presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Let's go to Phil in Puerto Rico. Hey, Phil, what's going on?
Hey, Tom, doing great. Just wanted to thank you guys and the whole crew. Best content on the internet. Really appreciate everything you guys are doing.
We appreciate you growling and prowling with us out here. Phil, how did you find us?
I just typed in live trading and YouTube one morning.
Cool.
I was looking for any type of live trading room. You guys came up. And,
awesome.
I know quality when I see it, or at least I like to think so. And I mean, you guys are just a dream. I appreciate everything you guys do.
Welcome to the Tiger family. We appreciate your growling and prowling with us.
My pleasure.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 7 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Be impeccable with your word. Manifest your true intentions. Regardless of what language you speak, your intent will be manifested through the word. What you dream, what you feel, and what you really are will be manifested through what you say each and every day. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 97, NASDAQ up 238, S&P's up 46. Gold contract up $7.70, trading at $21.65. We have silver up 5 cents, $24.55 an ounce, late sweet crude. Down 24 cents, $78.89 a barrel, notes and bonds. 10-year note up 4 ticks, trading 111.20. The 30-year flat at 121.19 in King Dollar. King Dollar's down 512 ticks at 102.857. Euro's 109, yen's 148, British pound's 128 to 1 US dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? Well, this is the small ABC that we got happening here. So you're up 460 at 514. The ABC on the SPY is 521, folks. And what we had done there was that you took out the B point. You took it out about a week ago. Small ABC, but it's not a small ABC because of the fact we're dealing with large numbers right now. But 521 is the number. Inside the NDX 100, the three Qs. Same type of setup inside the Qs. 4.53. Inside the Qs, we're up 6 right now at 4.45. It's 4.53. That's the A to B equals C to D. And I expect we're going to get it because if we go over to this dollar, you know, the dollar was up for, you know, quite some time, man. Bottom line, it built cause, broke the consolidation, got in a lower range. Trading at its lows right now. The dollar's making its way down to, you know, this 101 to 100 area, 600.617 rather. And let me take this dollar. I'm going to put this on a higher range. Yeah, look at this. This is cool. Okay, so 1 second. What is this number here? Ah, look at this. So what you have here is this. Getting down to that, you know, 199 area. Actually, 1 second, though. Let's do this one. Do it this way. So, one. Is that 103? 102? 101.800. So, at 101.800, you're really getting in a lower range, which can put, on a longer term basis, this back into the 86 area. Huh? No, 86 area. 86 to 90. This is going to get really interesting, man, because if that's where we're going, it's going to be a wild market. Let's take a look at some of the higher volume equities that we have out here today. You got Rivian is up $1.30. Yeah, they're closing up. They're going to stop making, they're going to not close a factory. They're working on a factory, but they're going to stop working, which is saving them some bread, a lot of bread, actually. And NVIDIA's up $33. You got, let's do it this way. Let's go inside the NDX 100 first, and we'll see the winners and losers. So inside the NDX, you got onsemi up 7%. Microchip, yeah, technology's up 6%. You got Qualcomm up 5%. You got ASML up 4%. So the chips are roaring. Taken away from it, we have CoStar. Now, CoStar, folks, is, let's look at this, because CoStar, I use CoStar, is down 2.4%. CoStar is for commercial property. Look at that. That's hanging tight. Well, maybe people are paying dues because they want to know so much. Yeah, it is. It's hanging up there. I guess that's what's going on. There's so many people that, this would be one of the best sites telling you what's happening with the commercial real estate market. That's interesting, man. It is staying at high, so that means that people are paying for the service. You got Kraft Heinz is down 2%. You got T-Mobile off 1%. You got Amgen off 1.7%. Inside the Dow Industrials, we take a look inside the Dow Industrials. And point-wise out here, you got Microsoft putting 37 positive points, Caterpillar 31%. American Express 27%, taken away from it. You got Amgen minus 32%, Visa minus 12%. Rest of them are small numbers, man. Yeah, they're definitely small numbers out there. We get into the note and bond market. Now, we get jobs numbers coming out tomorrow. And, you know, like every jobs number, it's going to move the market. We take a look at this 10-year right now. The 10-year is up 4 ticks. We are yielding 4.09, and the last 6 months, I think it's 4.990, lowest 3.7. So we're at 4.09. It's getting little by little. The TLT, this is the 20-year plus ETF structure. We take a look at this baby. Yeah, it's still down 17 pennies right now. We go take a look at a couple equities for the Tigers out here. So if we'll take a look at first, Anglo Ashanti, Anglo Gold Ashanti. The low for the year is 14, the high is 30. You're trading at 22. This is a strong equity, man. Big time, too. This is one of the strongest equities, actually, in the gold report. Yeah, so this is already taken off the swings. This is on its way up to that, $30? And you're at, right now you're at 22. IAG, IM Gold. We take a look at IM Gold. This is up 7 cents. This has been on a one-way trip on the way up also. Look at this. Broke the whole consolidation this week. Yep. Got to bring this back a little bit more. This is pretty cool. Yeah. Nice big volume. Well, next stop here is 320. Keep up with this volume. This is going to go a lot higher. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Currencies, commodities, and bond markets are as important as ever right now with how they're driving the volatility in equity markets across the globe, which is why it's a great time to try out Teddy Kegstat's Tiger Forex Report. Teddy Kegstat breaks down the Forex markets every Monday using his 30-plus years of experience as a trading veteran of futures, Forex, stocks, and options. Teddy releases his weekly Tiger Forex Report every Monday morning with coverage of all the major currency pairs, including the dollar index, the euro dollar, pound dollar, dollar Swiss, dollar yen, as well as many more, and he also has weekly coverage of the crude oil market and the 30-year T-bonds, as they both influence Forex markets tremendously. When you sign up for the Tiger Forex Report, you also gain instant access to Teddy's 60-minute webinar archive he just hosted, Forex Strategies and Fundamentals, What is Behind the Tiger Forex Report. For all the details and to start your 30-day Tiger Forex Report subscription today, visit the front page of TFNN.com. TFNN, educating investors.
Are you ready to take your trading to the next level? Introducing Tom O'Brien's award-winning newsletter, Market Insights, your key to successful active trading. Tom O'Brien, renowned for his expertise in the financial markets, has designed Market Insights to be your daily guide to profitable trades. Tom publishes his daily Market Insights newsletter every market day before the market open, along with updates when warranted. Stay ahead of the game with Tom's real-time analysis and trade recommendations delivered straight to your inbox. Whether you're a seasoned trader or just starting out, Market Insights provides the edge you need to navigate the markets with confidence. Ready to join the ranks of successful traders? Head over to TFNN.com and subscribe to Market Insights today. Don't miss out on this opportunity to supercharge your trading results. Market Insights comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee for all new subscribers, so you have nothing to risk. Don't miss out on this opportunity to revolutionize your trading game. Head over to TFNN.com right now to join thousands of traders who have already experienced the power of Tom O'Brien's award-winning newsletter, Market Insights, firsthand. TFNN, educating investors.
Are you ready to take charge of your financial future? TFNN is your gateway to the world of trading and investing. Whether you're starting out or scaling up, TFNN empowers traders and investors of all skill levels with top-notch investing systems, strategies, and techniques. It's time to protect and grow your money with insight you can trust. Join us live Monday through Friday during market hours for exclusive content that moves with the markets. At TFNN, we bring the trading floor to you. Our seasoned hosts are here to answer your calls and questions live on the air. Check out the Tiger's Den for just $1 and follow us on YouTube and become part of our vibrant community. And remember, at TFNN, we're so confident in the value we provide that we offer a 30-day money-back guarantee on all new premium newsletter subscriptions and services. You have absolutely nothing to risk, so why wait? Tune in live to Tiger TV and transform your trading journey, because when you know better, you invest better. Join us and experience the difference today. TFNN, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Dow's trading up 108, Nasdaq's up at 230, S&P's are up 45. Let's go take a look at this GDX and see where we're standing here. These markets have been a one-way move. No two ways about that. So you get a contraction of volume up here, right? We got a nice run that's happening. And it's like, okay, you're going to move sideways. You're going to pull back a bit. What do you want to do? Well, I know one thing inside gold, folks, okay? Once gold starts moving, it doesn't want to let you in. So, like, it's so tempting that, you know, it's like, okay, should you take something off the table here? With the dollar lower, my take is that, you know, this thing could, well, we'll see. You know, as soon as you say that, this thing can go for a while, it's like, yeah, well, it's going to stop dead in its tracks, man. The XAU, let's go take a look at the XAU and the HUI as to what kind of volumes that we got here. So we take a look at the XAU first. Now, I'll get the volumes in for today, tonight at 8 o'clock. Yeah, they're steady, man. Look at that. 3 days in a row. So the XAU, HUI, steady. I'll pull up the HUI simultaneously, but I suspect it's going to be the same thing. Because that's, you know, you got some contraction in the individual equities, but actually when you take a look at this, that volume is holding up pretty good inside the HUI and the XAU. It's pretty wild. Let's get over to our man, Mr. Tim Moore, as we do every Tuesday and Thursday. And don't forget, folks, you can reach Tim every trading day at ord-oracle.com. That's ord-oracle.com. Tim Ord, what's going on, brother?
Well, actually, well, kind of a lot of nothing. It's really, market's really persistent here. This is the week before option expiration week. And we got, you know, hammered on Monday. And I thought that at least at a minimum would be retested. We didn't. We pushed higher, and today we're higher again. And the VIX is up the last 3 days, with the S&P's up the last 3 days. So a little bit confusing, but you got to look at the bigger picture. You can take a look at chart one.
Okay. Wait, so let me get these. This is, okay.
Yeah. Yeah, it's kind of the old story here, but it's just worth, you know, it's worth reminding that, you know, we're in a bullish mode on the bigger time frame. The third window up from the bottom is that 60-day, 3-day trend again. And over the last week, it hasn't changed. It's still at 1.12.
Nice.
Anything above one? Okay. Yeah. Anything above 1.1 is bullish. You know, can we keep pushing higher? You know, it's a possibility. So anyhow, that particular chart shows that there's enough panic in the market. Trend readings above, at least on a 63-day, anything above 1.1 is bullish. On a 1 to 10 day, is anything above 1.2 is bullish, but on a 63-day, it remains bullish. So let's go to chart two.
And you know, I just want to add some. We're going to get some help on this today too, Tim, because even though the market's up, the trend's running 1.33 right now.
Yeah, I'm watching that. I've been watching that all day, and so I've seen where that trend actually gives a buy signal when the market's going up.
No, I get it. I know what you're saying. I've been looking at the trend long enough myself that, folks, what we're talking about is this. This is so unusual. So, because what this is saying, even though the market's up, people are selling, man. They're selling. That's wild, man.
Yeah, there's more stocks on the down, or there's more volume on the down stocks than up stocks. So,
amazing.
Which is what you want to have. So.
Yeah, no, I'm with you.
Yeah, it's a good point.
Okay, so I went.
Know, chart two.
Yep.
Chart two is the RSI on the daily. Yeah, this is daily. You know, back in December, we hit above 80, warning that we're probably going to start a trending market, and that's pretty much what it's done so far. And this chart goes way back to 2006. And so a lot of times that when the RSI hits 80 on the daily, a lot of times you're at the midpoint of the move up, and it doesn't happen very much. You know, you get this type of signal, you know, once every 2-3 years, maybe 4 years, but it's pretty rare. But once you get them, you want to stay long and be long, I guess you might say.
You want to latch on to it. Right.
Yeah, so those are kind of two bigger trends or which are up. And chart number three, here's what I'm kind of looking for the short term here. And actually, forget three, let's jump to chart four real quick.
Okay, 1 second. That's two, three, four. And you know, and you just mentioned 2006, Tim. Today's the anniversary of the market hitting the lows in 2000, and I think it's 2009. At 666 on the S&P. How's that?
I think I remember that.
Yeah, we definitely remember that.
Hey, isn't tonight the president's speech or something?
Yes.
That's tonight.
That's the State of the Union tonight.
State of the Union. So maybe we'll have some sort of reaction tomorrow. I don't know.
Yeah.
But
yeah,
chart number four is the weekly RSI. On a 14-time frame, anyhow. So not the daily RSI,
okay.
But the weekly RSI. And when it gets to, you know, around 80 and below 85, it gets above 85, you're kind of having a blow-off. But it gets up around 80, you got, pretty much an impulse wave. And that's pretty rare, too, all those tan areas. I try to mark them. Hopefully you can see them. So we're not in a market that you really want to look short. If the market does pull back, you want to buy it because it's going to find support. But, you know, last time we had something like this came in 80. That was back in 2020 going into that 2020 top. And before that was 2017, beginning of 2017.
So
what I'm thinking in general, this market, you know, because it's trending in such a strong way, I think this market's probably going to trend all the way into July. Is how I'm thinking it. There'll be some minor weeks down, but nothing major. So,
ride 'em, cowboy.
So pardon?
I said, ride 'em, cowboy.
Yeah, right. So nothing really major popping up as far as decline goes. So let's go back to chart number three.
Okay.
And what I'm kind of looking for here is exactly what you said, the trend. You know, I was hoping the trend would be up today. We got 1.12 is good, but the bottom two windows, the bottom window is the three-day trend. The next one up is the two-day trend. And actually, I'd like to see at least one of those, if not both those, up around 1.2, 1.25. And I marked the times in the past when that happened over the last 6 months or so. And every time that got, you know, at that, you're at least looking for some sort of a low for a bounce or something. So I'm hoping, you know, maybe tomorrow after the State of the Union address, they, you know, they...
And the jobs number comes out tomorrow morning, too, Tim.
Pardon?
The jobs number comes out tomorrow morning, too.
Yeah. All right, I'll hold.
Absolutely. Stay right there, folks. Tim Ward, Tom O'Brien, we do appreciate you growling and prowling with us. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. If you want to give Tim a call, give me a call. The Dow right now is up 107. NASDAQ's up 234. S&P's are up 46. Tim and I are coming right back, folks.
You might think that if you want to be successful at trading in the stock market, you're going to need a crystal ball. After all, it's impossible to predict the future, right? Like any endeavor in life, before you decide it's impossible, get some advice from the experts. You might find that it's not so impossible after all. For daily market overviews that give you direction on the key indices, selective stocks, and commodities, subscribe to the Opening Call newsletter at TFNN.com. The Opening Call newsletter is written by Basil Chapman, creator of the trading methodology known as the Chapman Wave. The Chapman Wave up-down sequence gives you an edge in identifying price turns, finding the peaks and valleys in stock prices. Get the Opening Call newsletter by Basil Chapman in your inbox every day. First-time subscribers also get a 30-day money-back guarantee. If you're not satisfied, let us know, and you'll get a full refund within 30 days of signing up. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Steve Rhodes started his trading career as a student almost 20 years ago, and the student has now become the master. Steve won the prestigious Timer of the Year award in 2018 and barely missed that mark again in 2019, finishing at number 2 for the year. An amazing accomplishment. Steve Rhodes is committed to sharing his techniques and knowledge with anyone who wants to learn, and he shares his vast amount of trading knowledge every day in his Mastering Probability newsletter. Steve's award-winning newsletter, Mastering Probability, is delivered every trading day with updates throughout the afternoon. Sign up for Steve's market newsletter, Mastering Probability, and you'll receive access to 7 of Steve's educational webinars absolutely free. At TFNN, all our newsletters come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have absolutely nothing to worry about. Visit TFNN.com and try Mastering Probability 30 days risk-free today. TFNN, educating investors.
Sharpening your skills as an investor is like getting better at playing a musical instrument. You have to practice, sure, but you also need excellent instruction from experts. At TFNN, you'll get advice and guidance from the authority in technical market analysis. And it's not just dry, tedious text either. TFNN airs live financial content streamed live on TFNN.com and TFNN's YouTube channel with Tiger TV, live every market day from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern, for free. Each host is an experienced trader and gives their take on the market while taking calls and questions live from around the world. From the moment the market opens until the closing bell sounds, Tiger TV has 8 different shows with expert hosts to help you make the right moves with your money. Watch online at TFNN.com or on TFNN's YouTube channel and become the investor you were born to be. TFNN, educating investors.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV.
Welcome back, folks. The Dow's up 100, NASDAQ's up 233, S&P's are up 46. We're talking with our man, Mr. Tim Wood, and we are talking markets out here. Okay, Tim, we're ready.
All right, let's go to chart 5.
Okay.
Yeah, this is a gold market, so, yep. You know, this thing, just you really want to see, especially off of a bottom, You know, if the market can really show a sign of strength off the bottom, that's what you want to see. But, you know, this the bottom two windows is the 18-day average of the up-down volume for GDX.
Okay.
And the next window up is advanced decline 18-day average for GDX. In a nutshell, when both those indicators are above minus 10, you got an uptrend going. And so all the light blue areas are times when this indicator is above minus 10, and when it's below minus 10, it's in that pink area. So we're coming in, you know, obviously we're way above minus 10 in both situations.
Yes.
And the market has been up. I think today will be we stay up today, which probably will be up 6 days in a row. But, you know, let's go to chart two.
Okay.
Or chart six. I'm sorry, chart six.
Okay.
We talked about this back in probably August of last year.
Yep.
And anyhow, we'll go through it real quick, but the bottom two windows are the same indicators that we had on chart number five.
Okay.
But what I want to see here is both these indicators get to plus 40.
Okay.
And those blue lines on the chart show the times when you get to plus 40 in the past.
Now, is this a weekly we're looking at, Tim, or a monthly or a daily?
No, this is a daily.
Daily,
this
okay,
is
cool.
Actually,
okay.
The same chart as of chart number five, but it goes back further, and so it doesn't quite look the same.
Okay, that's cool.
So
yep.
It's the same two indicators, but what you want to see is both of them get to plus 40.
I see.
And so back in 2016, we got to plus 40 right off the bat, and went higher from February to August, and went higher for another 6 months, and we. This did get back, if you go to the current time frames of last year, April, yeah, it looks like April or so, it got to plus 40. And I was saying on the air, we were talking about it, well, this is probably initiation of an up move and we should keep going. Well, it didn't. It fell back.
It failed, yeah. No, I'm with you, right, yeah.
Right, and so that was basically a failure, I guess. There's always... Not all the indicators work all the time.
Sure.
This time it didn't work, but
right.
The previous four did. My point is, you know, we're coming in right now. You know, both of them are approaching 20, a little bit less than 20, but 20. So for get to plus 40, we need in general for the GDX to keep moving higher. You know, you can have it down or 2 days, but you can't have it down or 2 weeks because that would ruin this indicator not getting to plus 40. But we can get to plus 40 on this, which is a big F. You know, we got 20 now. We need to get to 40. If we get to 40, then the odds suggest that we got a big impulse wave going.
Right.
Now, if we do get that going, let's go to chart five.
Okay.
This is the hope. What we're trying to do on chart five is get the bottom indicator, which is the monthly cumulative advanced decline, and the top window is the monthly cumulative up-down volume percent, to get these two indicators above the mid-Bollinger band.
Yes.
Now, if we can do that, you got a multi-year rally going. Be something like the 2002 low or the 2016 low.
Bring it on.
Or the 2019 low.
Yeah, bring the 2002 low on, will you?
Yeah. Yeah, that's what I'm thinking is coming at some point, because this market can't really trade forever going sideways.
Well, you know, it's interesting, you know, too. Yeah, and there's been enough failures when we've gone higher.
Right.
And then what you also have, which is pretty cool, is that the price of gold versus the price of the equities, gold is way ahead of the equities, folks, okay?
Right.
Which is really so
right.
Cool, man, okay? So there can be
right.
a catch-up.
Right. We showed a chart on Tuesday with the XAU gold ratio.
Yes.
And that RSI got below 30, I don't know, last week, maybe the week before. And that gave a buy signal. So, in other words, that ratio went right through the floor over the last couple of months because that's what needs to happen to get the RSI below 30. So that indicator actually gave a buy signal, the XAU gold ratio, if you look at...
Yes.
I don't have those charts.
No, I remember it well. Yep, absolutely.
Right. So, basically, when the XAU looks the ugliest, it's the most... especially on a monthly time frame, when it looks the ugliest, it's most of the opportune time to get in.
Yes.
So I don't know, but that ratio kind of really brought everything down. Now, so you had a selling climax on that ratio. You know, just like a bull market, you need a selling climax. Then right after it, you need a buying climax. You know, remember we were talking about the summation index?
Oh, yeah.
The summation index. You need a selling climax below minus 700. Then you need a buying climax to plus 1,000 to predict a bull market for the equity market. Well, that same thing can happen with the XAU gold ratio. You get a selling climax, you get an RSI below 30, then you need a buying climax. So you need a rush of buying come in to get a bull market. So I'm thinking this is kind of developing this way. That's the reason why I put some of these charts up. Like if you go back to chart 6, if we can get to plus 40 here in the next couple, 3 weeks, and there's a good chance if you go to then to chart 7, you'll get that both those GDX up, down, volume, advanced client indicators above the Bollinger Band. So that's why I'm hoping that it could happen.
Yes.
It's going to happen. Now, but if you go back to chart 7,
okay,
it's a lagging indicator. It doesn't try to catch the bottom or top, but does catch the middle 80%. So it already made its bottom if we get above the mid Bollinger Band. And so the bottom could have happened, you know, in February, because a lot of times February in the gold market are reversals, and that's happened this year.
Okay.
And July is important. October are important months. So we'll see in the coming months. But I'll be watching this monthly GDX real carefully. So if we get up by that Bollinger Band on both those indicators, then we'll start something that's as significant. You know, we'll be like 2000. Well, maybe. Maybe not, but at least be like 2019 and 2016. Because we've been going down, you know, if you look at this chart, since 2021, both those indicators have been below his mid Bollinger Band going back to 2021, which says basically it's advanced decline and up-down volume that the market's pretty much been in a bear market because, you know, it was tough to make money in the gold market, especially gold equities.
Yes.
And once you get above that mid Bollinger Band, then almost all gold stocks are going up. It'll be fairly easy to make money. So will that happen? You know,
we'll see.
We got the indicators to watch to see if it does. If it does, we'll know it.
Cool here, folks. Remember, these programs are archived because as Tim's speaking, he's giving you the numbers to look for. And that's what's so cool you know, us going forward, you know, just keep watching the numbers. Stay right there. Tim and I are coming right back. We have the Dow Industrials up 133, NASDAQ's up 240, S&Ps are up 50. We're coming right back.
If you're looking for potential trading setups in the stock market, then Rocket Equities and Options Report is a newsletter you should try. Tommy O'Brien delivers options and equity trades when the markets present them using a combination of fundamentals and technicals. Sign up for Rocket Equities and Options Report today with a 30-day money-back guarantee so you have nothing to risk. For all the details and to start your subscription today, visit the front page of TFNN.com. TFNN, educating investors.
Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
The reality is that navigating financial markets can be risky. Markets can be chaotic and difficult to understand. Having the latest market advice can help you turn this chaos into a key for creating winning trades. At TFNN, we understand that it can be hard to find reliable market news. That's why each of our market experts offers their very own market newsletter, a must-have tool for every trader out there striving to find an edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets so you can analyze the market before you trade. Try any of our great newsletters risk-free with our 30-day money-back guarantee. Just visit the newsletters tab on the front page of TFNN.com. TFNN, educating investors.
TFNN has launched the Tiger's Den, hosted at Discord. TFNN has been educating traders for more than 20 years with live programming hosted by a variety of professional traders during market hours. The Tiger's Den, available to all tigers and tigresses for just $1 for the year. There's no catch or added costs when you join our community of traders. Sign up today and become a part of this educational community of traders. Just visit the front page of TFNN.com.
This program is brought to you by Vista Gold, traded on the NYSE American and TSX under the symbol VGZ.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Tim Moore, Tom O'Brien. We do appreciate you growling and prowling with us. We have the Dow right now up 156, NASDAQ's up 253, S&Ps are up 53. And we're talking with our man, Mr. Tim Moore, and we are talking gold right now.
Yeah, I don't know what to say about gold. You're just...
Oh, the GDX, rather, yeah.
The chart on 7, though, is, in my opinion, the whole key to get this thing turned up. And I put that in my market letter. So if we can get that turned up, then anybody holding gold stocks will turn into a genius because everything they'll touch most likely will go up.
I know.
But until then, you know, everything's been kind of selective. You know, it's been a beating, but there are some gold stocks that have gone up over the last couple of years, but not many.
Oh yeah, no, we know how this goes. Yeah, so, let's take a quick call. We got to call the folks. I mean, Tim, that wants to talk to you about the QQQ. Let's go to Ron in Charlotte. Hey, Ron, what's going on?
Yes, hi, Tom. How are you?
I'm doing great. Yourself?
Good. I was calling about a couple of things. 416 on the QQQ. Do you think that's still in the cards based on the strength we've seen the past couple of days?
Are you talking to Tom or me?
I'm actually talking to Tom right now, but I do have a question for you, Tim. And thank you.
Well, so I suspect that those are going to get tested. The real question is, as I said at the beginning of the show, the Qs are in an ABC up to 453, and we're only at 445. So that ABC is going to finish. That's what it looks like to me.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It's a small one, but because we're at such big numbers, it ends up being a good-sized chunk A to B. Do you know what I'm saying? So.
Right. Yeah. Cool. Okay, good. So, yeah, we can expect 453 before a serious downturn.
That's what it looks to me. And I don't see a serious downturn. But what does happen markets in general.
You know, something. Pardon me.
No, just in general. You know, and Tim and I talked about it. If this gap doesn't get filled, all of us that are long the market, man, is going to be in. I don't like it when they don't get filled, man. Do you know what I mean? Because if you go seriously higher, then it's going to get filled, man. It's way too big. But this gap is just way too big, man. So
yeah. And for Tim, and thanks, Tom. For Tim, the Tuesday low. Do you think that's going to be retested?
Tuesday's low. I think it might. We haven't touched that. We got a gap. Also, you know, Nasdaq's got a gap. Around that. Well. And the midpoints look like about 430. You know, the SP's got a gap there too. And actually, I don't think it's going to get filled this week or next week. But I think it could get filled the week after expiration week. I think especially March, which is a quarter expiration week. You got March, June, September, and December. We're all quarter expiration weeks. And those quarters seem to lean bullish. And so we only got one more trading day, a day to go. So I don't think tomorrow we're going to test that gap, or actually be what, today's Thursday, be Tuesday's low. And so I think the market may hold steady, if not up, next week. But I think the week after, it could. That's how I'm looking at it. And that's probably when the gap might get filled. But not next not next week. So so if you're short, you know, I'd kind of be a little bit scared here because, you know, if we get a little panic going in here, it'd really set up for a bull market on, you know, get some energy to the upside. But I think this week's going to be up. Next week's going to be up. How much? I don't know. But I think the week after, of all the seasonalities, the week after option expiration week on March is the eighth weakest week of the year, according to seasonality. So it's a week to pay attention to. But, you know, next week could be, it could be just sideways, so we'll have to wait and see. So I hope that answers your question.
Appreciate you guys. Appreciate you both so much.
Okay, man. Ron, you have a great one, a safe one. Appreciate it. Appreciate the call.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
You know, this run in the markets, Tim, we've seen them, but this is something else, man. I remember having, and I think you were on the line at that particular point. If not, you just got off the line. This is a long time ago I'm talking about. But Bollinger, I used to interview him quite a bit. And John Bollinger, this is, folks. And he was explaining, this is when Yahoo was going right through the roof. And what it was actually doing, it was, he was calling it, it was grabbing the top of the Bollinger Band and riding it. And I remember this so well because it's like, I was saying to him, like, how far, how long can this do it? He says, man, until it doesn't do it.
And Actually, if you can ride, you know, just touching the upper Bollinger Band,
right?
But that's fine. But once you start going through it, like we did
it was
March? Yeah, March, we're above it right now, right? We have that chart.
Yeah.
On the monthly time frame.
Right.
So I'm thinking, you know, I'm thinking, well, we should get a pullback of some sort here because we, or was that February we closed above 50% above the Bollinger Band? I think it was February.
It was February,
so
That would it was February.
Right,
I got
so
it
that
up
would
right now.
Predict March, which is this month, it could be a little trouble. So I don't see a trouble coming this week or next week. It's the week after, because the week after is the eighth, you know, weakest week of the year. And it works pretty well. So we may get hit, and that's when the we may see the gap fills on both the QQQ and the SPYs. And then from there you start going up. So I don't know. That's my opinion. That may change going forward. But, if you can ride the upper Bollinger Band, just keep on it, that's great. But once you start going above it, then that's when the ugly could happen.
Exactly.
So
yep.
We'll see how that happens.
Pretty cool, man, I'm telling you. And then, you know, what we have now the last 2 days, Tim, is that the dollar index, okay, you know, that had been staying really strong, and we're at 102.800 right now, and this was hanging above what it had done. It was having a hard, well, my take is that it was going lower, and it finally did break the consolidation. But I mean, it went sideways for, you know, 10 days trying to get into this consolidation, into lower range, and it just refused it. But then as soon as it broke, we got 2 days in a row of it breaking. So that looks to me like the dollar's going to get down to 100 right now, when we're at 102.822, which, you know, the S&P loves a weak dollar, the commodity market loves a weak dollar. I mean, this could get really interesting, man, so...
Yeah, I think so too. I think this March stuff though is just a little bit peculiar because I always thought we'd be pulling back today and we're up. But you know, maybe that, you know, I forgot the state. A lot of times you get these announcements going on, State of the Union or some other you know unforeseen information coming out that the market gets affected by. So yeah. I think the State of the Union personally is having an effect on the market. But
well, yeah, listen, man, it's always a pleasure. You have a great weekend, a safe weekend, and we look forward to talking to you next Tuesday, Tim.
All right. Love you guys.
Love you, man.
Have a good one.
Have a great one. Have a safe one. Dow right now up 121. NASDAQ up 237. S&P's up 48. We're going to be coming right back.
Are you ready to take your trading to the next level? Introducing Tom O'Brien's award-winning newsletter, Market Insights, your key to successful active trading. Tom O'Brien, renowned for his expertise in the financial markets, has designed Market Insights to be your daily guide to profitable trades. Tom publishes his daily Market Insights newsletter every market day before the market open, along with updates when warranted. Stay ahead of the game with Tom's real-time analysis and trade recommendations delivered straight to your inbox. Whether you're a seasoned trader or just starting out, Market Insights provides the edge you need to navigate the markets with confidence. Ready to join the ranks of successful traders? Head over to TFNN.com and subscribe to Market Insights today. Don't miss out on this opportunity to supercharge your trading results. Market Insights comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee for all new subscribers, so you have nothing to risk. Don't miss out on this opportunity to revolutionize your trading game. Head over to TFNN.com right now to join the thousands of traders who have already experienced the power of Tom O'Brien's award-winning newsletter, Market Insights, firsthand. TFNN, educating investors.
Everything in the universe is governed by the Fibonacci sequence. This mathematical principle is responsible for everything from the most aesthetically pleasing artwork to patterns in the stock market. To stay on top of stock patterns you can take advantage of, sign up for the Fibonacci 24/7 newsletter at TFNN.com. When you subscribe, you'll get a weekly report from veteran day trader Larry Pesavento on stocks you need to pay attention to. And you can trust Larry's analysis. After all, he's got 45 years experience as a day trader. Larry will also provide daily charts, videos, and data on the key markets that he's tracking. Expect notifications from Larry on market movement you need to act on at any time. First-time subscribers also get a 30-day money-back guarantee. If you're not satisfied, let us know and you'll get a full refund within 30 days of signing up. Subscribe to the Fibonacci 24/7 newsletter today. TFNN.com, educating investors.
The reality is that navigating financial markets can be risky. Markets can be chaotic and difficult to understand. Having the latest market advice can help you turn this chaos into a key for creating winning trades. At TFNN, we understand that it can be hard to find reliable market news. That's why each of our market experts offers their very own market newsletter. A must-have tool for every trader out there striving to find an edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets so you can analyze the market before you trade. Try any of our great newsletters risk-free with our 30-day money-back guarantee. Just visit the newsletters tab on the front page of TFNN.com. TFNN. Educating investors.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go to John in Lakeland. Hey, John, what's going on, brother?
Hey, how you doing?
I'm doing great, man. Yourself?
It's Jose, but it's neither.
Jose, what's happening, hey, man? How you been?
Yeah, great show. Hey, am I the only one suspicious of this one-way street with tech? Up, up, up. Even to a novice like me, it smells bad. And it smells of people holding tech right now. They want you to pay up here. Or pay higher. Buy it high or pay higher down the road. Is that, would you agree with that?
It's, you know, this is a real run. I totally understand what you're saying, because these runs like this are hard to believe. This run, you know, when I was on TD Ameritrade or the Schwab Network, and it was interesting because the host probably was Bond when I was bringing her back to 1994. This is kind of like... the run from 94, you know, up to 2000. I mean, we had like three or four, you know, heavy corrections, but each run was like insane. And, you know, that's where we're at. And I mean, you know me, I mean, I've gone shot a lot, man. And thank God I haven't been shot in a long time because, you know.
Very dangerous.
Well, I just caught on that this is, everything seems to be going. And now with the dollar croaking, man, if this dollar stays down, man, this market's going to go like bonkers. Just because what it would mean is that, yes, we're at higher number, but you can't buy, well, in the United States, you could buy more, right? But then if you transferred and went to Europe, you're going to buy less. You know what I mean? So it's a, like a tricky math little deal, but that's kind of how it works. So it's like, hey, man, it's running until it doesn't want to run. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Tom, hey, if Biden handlers are on the ball, he'll exploit this tonight. Be better.
Yeah, that's a fact. That's a fact. Always remember, folks, the bear can claw your heart out, the bull can run you over, and thank God there's always another trade. Health, happiness, and prosperity. Have a great night, folks. Have a safe night. Come back and visit Tommy tomorrow morning. Kicks us off 9 a.m. Great show, folks.